The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" The angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month of her who was called barren. For nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. My friends, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters. Never underestimate the power of God. Never underestimate the power of God. This is the lesson that we could learn from our gospel today, and also in our celebration of the queenship of Mary. Never underestimate the power of God. We heard in our gospel the story of the Annunciation of the Blessed Virgin Mary. We are familiar with that, right? Are you familiar? Yes. What's the name of the angel?
Gabriel.
What did the angel Gabriel announce to Mary? Yes, that she will bear the Son of God. She will become the mother of the Son of God. We know the story. We know the story. Of course, we also know that Mary asked a question. How can this be, since I have no relations with a man? Although Mary was already betrothed to Saint Joseph. What does betrothed means? Well, maybe in our language, it is the word engage. They are engaged to Mary. They have plans of getting married, but they're not yet married. So, how can this be? How could that be possible that she will bear a son if she has no relations with a man, if she's not yet married. But, of course, the angel Gabriel said, there is nothing impossible for God. The angel Gabriel detailed how everything will happen. And he even gave a proof. How will that happen? How could that be possible? Elizabeth, the relative of Mary, who was called barren, now pregnant. So, ibig sabihin, walang hindi mapangyayari ang Diyos. Kung ang baog nagbuntis, ang isa pa bang Maria hindi pwedeng magbuntis? Walang hindi mapangyayari ang Diyos. Look at the life of Mary. From an ordinary girl, God changed her life. Changed her life through her power. From an ordinary girl to a mother. And now, we remember Mary as our queen. Queen because being immaculate, being pure, she's the first to be with Jesus in heaven. Because of being pure, kaya nga tayo, we purify ourselves in everything that we do, with our decisions, we purify. Ito ba ang makakabuti? You don't only ask, ito ba ang tama? You ask, ito ba ang makakabuti? Because if it is good, then that will make you pure. Mary was spotless, walang bahid dungis. That's why she's the first to be with Jesus in heaven. Thus, we call her the Queen of Heaven and Earth. But Mary as a queen is different from the usual queen of the world that we know. Iba si Maria sa lahat ng mga reyna sa buong mundo. O baka sa mga nagre-reyna-reynahan. We have an idea of what a queen is, right? Meron ba tayong idea what a queen is? But Mary is different. Kung ang ibang reyna, sila ang nasusunod, sila ang nagpapasunod, si Maria, siya ang sumunod. Gaya ng pagsunod na ipinakita ni Maria nang tanggapin niya ang plano ng Diyos na maging ina ng kanyang anak. Buong buhay ni Maria, walang ginawa kundi ang sumunod sa Diyos. No matter how difficult it is, she followed God. Second, kung ang ibang reyna, sila ang namumuno, si Maria, siya ang namagitan. Some queen leads, but Mary intercedes. Ang mga reyna, dinadala tayo sa sarili nilang plano. Diba? Kaya ang reyna merong advocacy. Oh, diba? Pag mga Miss Universe, no? Yung mga sumasali sa Miss Universe, may advocacy. No? Advocacy to the poor, advocacy to the helpless, advocacy to those who are in need. Ganyan ang mga reyna. They will bring us to their plans. But with Mary, she brought us to the plan of God. Namagitan siya. Hindi siya namumuno. Namamagitan sa atin sa Diyos. Not in her own plan, but always in the plan of God. At panghuli, kung ang mga reyna, sila ang pinaglilingkuran, si Maria, siya ang naglingkod. Bilang ina, buong buhay ni Maria, pinaglingkuran niya si Jesus. mula sa kapanganakan hanggang sa kamatayan, andoon si Maria naglilingkod kay Jesus. Ganito ang buhay ni Maria bilang reyna. Kakaiba pero banal. Mahirap pero masaya. Puno ng pagsubok pero hindi nauubusan ng pag-asa. Lahat ito ay dahil walang imposible sa Diyos. Kaya niyang baguhin ang lahat basta tayo ay makikipagkaisa. God can change everything. We just have to cooperate. My dear brothers and sisters, if change happened to Mary, it can also happen to you. Because nothing is impossible with God. We just have to cooperate. Dalawa lang naman yan eh. Susunod o susuway ka? Eh alam mo na kung anong kalalagyan mo. Mary is a queen because of her service, kanyang pagdilingkod, intercession, kanyang pamamagitan, and because of her obedience, ang pagsunod sa Diyos. Amen.